Good morning or good day to you, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome again to our sermon series on unsung heroes in the Bible. Like we mentioned, these are people in the Bible that did great and mighty things for God, but sometimes go unnoticed, unheard of, because it is not the common names that we hear in the Bible. And today I'd like to talk to you about two unsung heroes in the Old Testament. And who are they? They are called Bezalel and Oholiab. What a strange name. We've heard Beelzebub, okay, we've heard a lot of other strange names, but Bezalel, I don't think you've heard, you have anyone among you, your friends or relatives that have this name Bezalel, or you have this name Oholiab, and people say, where did you get that name from? Is it from some foreign nation or something? They say, no, it's from the Bible. Now, who was Bezalel and Oholiab? Now, you find them in Exodus chapter 31, verse 2 to 6. Now, this is where they are constructing the temple, the house of God. Now, as they begin to construct the temple, they need different people with different skills. Just like if you want to build a house, you need people who are good in electrical, good in plumbing, good in construction, architect, design. You need different people with different skills. So when it came to building the temple of God, there were specific instructions that were given. There was a specific size. There was certain type of material, certain type of design that God wanted. And God chose these two special people called Bezalel and Oholiab. Now I'm going to read to you from Exodus chapter 31 onwards, from verse 1 onwards. And he says, "Then the Lord said to Moses, 'See, I have chosen Bezalel, son of Uri, the son of Hur, of the tribe of Judah. I have filled him with the Spirit of God, with skill, ability, and knowledge in all kinds of craft.'" Two things about Bezalel. He had the Spirit of God in him, and he had the skills, ability, and knowledge in his craft to make artistic designs for work in gold, silver, and bronze, to cut and set stones, to work in wood, and to engage in all kinds of craftsmanship. That is spoken about Bezalel. Now check out the next verse. "Moreover, I have appointed Oholiab, son of Ahisamach, alright, that's a pretty long word, of the tribe of Dan, to help him." Now what is said of Oholiab? "Also, I have given him skill to all the craftsmen to make everything I have commanded for the tent of meeting." Two people God chose. Now there were many craftsmen that were chosen, but two of which it is mentioned in the Bible. The list of all the craftsmen, I'm sure there were hundreds of them that were appointed, but two of them stand out and God mentions them by name and says, "I have chosen Bezalel to be that craftsman because I've put the Spirit of God in him and I've put every skill and ability in him. And I have chosen Oholiab to assist him in this." Now you see, sometimes when we think of people in the Bible, oh, you know, you must have an anointing, you must be able to preach, there must be miracles, signs, and wonders. Now I don't have anything against that. Yes, when we minister, when we preach, when we pray, when we lay hands on people, we want to see those miracles, signs, and wonders because that's a demonstration of God's power. But there are also other great and mighty ways that you can be used in ministry, and that is through your creative skill, your craftsmanship, your talent, your abilities. That was what Bezalel and Oholiab did. I want to encourage you today, serving God in ministry is not always standing like this, holding a Bible and preaching the Word of God. God may be calling you and telling you, look, your skill is music. Your skill is dancing. Your skill is art. Your skill is painting. You know, your skill is ballet or gymnastics. Whatever it is, turn it into something for ministry and use it for glory. It is so unique when God has given you a skill and you can be creative and ask God, how can I use this in ministry? How can I use this for greater glory? as Bezalel and Oholiab was used for God in a mighty way, I believe there are many hidden skills and abilities in you that is just waiting to come out. It is just sitting there dormant and just saying, open the door, I need to come out, I need to come out. So if you're good in painting, you're good in dancing, you're good in singing, you're good in a musical instrument, whatever it is, ask God, Lord, if you've given me this skill, put your spirit in me and show me how I can use it for your glory. And you can become a mighty vessel of God in His eyes. God bless you and have a good day.